Welcome student. In last period we have seen some flow charts, that is design steps in programming steps. As you know that we are studying chapter program analysis. So in this chapter we have seen there are 5 steps. Number 1, study the problem, understand the problem, decompose the problem. This problem is too large. That is analysis. Study problem means analysis. This step is important because only after studying this step, only this is the step by which we can come to the conclusion of input process and output. Input process and output. So for any program, what the input will require, how the processing will be, and what the output should be expected, this will be known when we study the problem. Unless until we study the problem, we can't come to the conclusion of input process and output. Once problem is studied, before writing a program we write down the steps in our simplest language. That is called as design steps. So what is my design steps? If problem is studied, problem is understood, and if conclusion of input process and output is there, then design step is the step in which a either flowchart or algorithm, either one will work. So flowchart, that is also part of design steps, because flowchart is symbolic representation of a program. Flowchart is not program, but not less than program. Why? Because it is a symbolic representation of a program. Algorithm, it is also a representation of program by using pseudo codes. So here is symbolic representation. Symbolic representation of program, and this is using pseudo code. So first step, study the problem, understand the problem, what the problem is, because program, that is set of instructions which can be given to computer in order to solve the problem. But the problem we have to study, because program, that is set of instruction in order to solve the problem. Program, that is set of instruction in order to solve the problem. So first of all, study the problem, understand the problem. Once problem is studied, write down the steps in our own language, simplest form, flowchart, symbolic representation of program. Symbolic representation because symbols are more easier to understand than the text or algorithm. But once these two steps are over, once these two steps are finished, it means we are ready to write a program on this computer. It means these are the two steps which are prior to the actual programming on the computer. Studying the problem, understanding the problem, write down the steps in our language, that is draw a flowchart or algorithm. But once these two steps are over, it means we are ready now to write a program in C++ or any language which we know. So we don't have to do anything now. Why? Because problem is studied, input process output we got, design steps are written in simplest form, just that steps are to be converted into programming language instructions which we know. That step is called as coding. In this step, convert
convert design steps in programming language instructions. Programming language instructions. Programming language instructions. Now you can ask the question, which programming language?
Whichever programming language that we know, any programming language will do. Why?
Because
we have written the steps in our form, simplest language.
Simply that we have to convert it to programming language.
Say, programming language is a C++. Then every symbol of flowchart or pseudocode will be converted into programming language instructions. So obviously there will be a program, a ready program. So after this step, program is ready. After this step, just input process output is gathered or conclude. Design steps, write down the steps in our language. Once the steps in our language are ready, convert every step into programming language instruction and type down the program. So program is ready. Now what? Once a program is there, definitely we are going to execute it. Run. What exactly mean by run or execute? Whatever the program is written by us, that we have to verify. For example, suppose program is of area of circle. So first study the problem. What input will require? Radius. Process 3.14 into R. Output A, that is area. Design steps. So we'll write down the design steps, that is flowchart. Coding, we will convert every symbol into the C++, say C++. So C++ program is ready. Now we will execute the program and verify whether the program is giving the correct output or not. So there will be testing. This step is also important. Actually, all these steps are important. Testing. Why testing is essential? Because our program is for area of circle. So we should verify. We must verify whether our program is giving correct output or not. So we will run the program. We will give such radius whose area we know already. For example, radius is 1. So area will be 3.14. Again we will verify. Once again we will run the program. Now this time we will give the input 2. R is a 2. Then area 6.28, whatever that should be obtained. So once it is sure, so we have to make sure ourselves that program is giving correct output. So make sure that program is giving correct output or not. It may possible that program is not giving the correct output, wrong output is there, area is not calculated properly. So then there are two chances of errors. That is, execute the program and verify output. If output is not correct, then there are errors. There may be the errors. Two types of errors. One, syntax error stands for error in programming language grammar is known as syntax. So it may possible that we have violated rules of programming languages, then there will be the error. Or logical error. What the logical error means wrong formula. It may possible that by mistake formula is written in wrong method by us, so there may be the wrong answer. That's why it is called a logical error. So eliminate the error, once again verify the output. And last, the documentation. What is my documentation? Validation of program. Validation. Validation means whether input that is radius is to be given in particular range 1 to 100, or it is in fractional part. So we have to validate that. Similarly, author of the program, who has written the program, that is called as a documentation. So these are the steps. These are the steps which we have seen in this chapter. That is studying the problem, design steps, coding, testing, documentation. Study problem, design steps, coding, testing, documentation. So these are the 5 steps, and these steps are important. These 2 steps which do not require computer system directly. This is paperwork. Coding is the step where PC is required, computer is required, and write out the program. Testing is the step, verify the documentation is there. So these are the 5 steps. Now these 2 steps we are studying. We have used, we have gone through these 2 steps. Just coding step we have not done. Why? Because right now we don't know any programming language, and coding is the step in which convert the design step into programming language. But right now we don't know any programming language. That's why coding is the step now which we can't go through. We can study the problem, it means we can go through this step. We can write down the flowchart, draw the flowchart, or write down the algorithm, even we can go through design steps. But coding, we must know the programming language, and hence, next chapter is the programming language we have to study, that is C++. So our next period, in next period, we are going to study the C++ programming language, by which we can coding, we can do the coding, we can run the program, we can verify the output. So I think you have got here, this chapter number 2 is concluded. Thank you.